Hey there, my friends. This is Guy Ferdman of Satori Prime. And in this video, I'm gonna be illustrating for you how you can spend and invest more of your time in the present, in the now. Now, if you've been in the personal or spiritual development game for any amount of time, I'm sure you've heard over and over and over again to invest more of your time in the now. Maybe you have a meditation practice. Maybe you're taking a lot of personal development courses. But in this video, I really wanna give you a diagram of how it is that we perceive reality and actually what it is that takes us out of the now. Because if you check out your mind and how it operates, it's a beautiful tool and it's really organized around a lot protecting you and having you survive life. Oftentimes, if you check it out, right, your mind is either regretting something that happened in the past, it's kind of attached to it, maybe it's feeling bad about it and kind of punishing you over it or punishing somebody else, or it's in the worry stage where it's kind of worried about the future, something that may be coming, maybe not coming, and it kind of ping-pongs back and forth between these two elements. Now, here at Satori Prime, we teach a really simple kind of philosophy, which is to stop trying to make yourself feel better. We've noticed that most people, we were guilty of it as well for many, many years, do personal development in order to make themselves feel better. Now, that's a really idealistic thing, but if you've been doing personal development for a long time, I'm certain that you've seen results from your work. If you check out deep inside, you may feel that you actually don't feel that much different than you felt before. Maybe you're still quick to anger. Maybe you're still berating yourself. Maybe you still feel betrayed by the people in your life. And that's really what's not shifting, because that comes into the body and that's a sensorial, like a sense experience that happens here within the body. So I wanna explain to you and give you a diagram of really what happens when we're experiencing something that's really outside of our control, because most of life is really outside of our control, even though the mind will have you thinking that you can control what's happening right now. Because for the most part, we have these circumstances that are all around us, right? Things that we're all dealing with, whether it's internal or external, we're dealing with something. And the body is responding sensorially, meaning that maybe you feel like a clenching in your stomach and you know you get afraid of something, or maybe there's a heaviness on your heart and it's like clamping and you feel kind of sad, or maybe there's like a fogginess up here and you're dealing with anger, whatever it might be. Notice that those things are happening, and no matter how much understanding you create or how many five, you know, step formulas the next guru or mentor gives you, that really doesn't help you with that in the moment where you're having these big emotional sensorial experiences. So again, if we check this out, maybe something is happening in your life right now, some circumstance, and then some pattern shows up that's shown up a million times. Maybe it's betrayal that you feel, or all alone, or unloved, or stupid, or any of the other thousands of things that we make up about ourselves that we made up when we were children in order to survive certain things that were happening in our lives. So these strategies became patterns, energetic patterns in the body. Here comes the stimulus. Your body responds, right? There's a tightness in the stomach and your mind is watching this because your mind is built to protect you from the anxiety, stress, and overwhelm. It's trying to buffer you from those experiences. So the mind is watching and it's fixating on that experience in your body, and then it starts telling you a story. And this story is a distortion, but it uses this distortion because this distortion has historically worked to change your perception to try to buffer you from the experience that you're having in your body. Now, the moment that the mind does this, you are no longer with what is happening in reality, in your body, in the sensations of your body. And this is why we say stop trying to make yourself feel better and start getting better at feeling. Because if you want to be in the present, you want to start feeling what's actually happening in the present. The mind has a way of subduing things or pushing them back down, and what it doesn't allow for is for energy to move. Energy in motion is an emotion. That's why we call it emotion, right? It's energy in motion. But by the time you've called it anger or any other thing that you use to diagram how you're feeling sensations in your body, that's just a judgment of the mind about the sensation in the body. But the reality is that there's a sensation in the body. And if we can just get present to where is the sensation in the body, and how is my mind trying to protect myself from this without doing anything about it? Just the same way that you might get a cut on your finger or that a woman might get pregnant, notice that you actually don't have to give your body any feedback in order for you to heal or for that life to be born inside a woman's body. There's a divine connection and intelligence to our body that's always been there, and it's been there since the start of time. And yet when it comes to the circumstances in our life, instead of trusting and this intelligence, we often try to give it input and tell it where to go. And this is what actually takes us out of the present, takes us out of our alignment, and takes us out of our divine connection, which allows us to have major breakthroughs and release, actually have the energy move out of our body and actually heal these things within ourselves, so that the experiences you might be having around betrayal or loneliness or sadness or anger or anything else that you might be experiencing actually get to move out of the body and naturally heal the same way that your finger would heal if you cut it. My name is Guy Ferdman. I'm a coach and mentor at Satori Prime. And if you're enjoying this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe so that you can receive our weekly new training videos that come out. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you on the next one.